Welcome all of you in the second lecture. The topic is transmission lines, and last class we had some discussion about the introduction as well as what are the parameters of transmission lines. Today we are going to study some depth about it. So in this figure you can see a transmission line has been explained using the coaxial wire. And in this case, or we can say generally, transmission line contains two conductors. These two conductors are required to add source to the load. Here in this figure you can see the source we have considered as a generator, okay, and the load is considered here, and in load side RL is there, that is load resistance. And in source side we have RG, that is source resistance, as well as the source voltage is given, which is sinusoidal in nature. So this is one example which has been shown with the help of a coaxial wire. It means the source and the load is connected with a transmission line over the distance, and the transmission line contains two conductors to connect source and load. So I will be telling you the equivalent circuit as well as the exact setup, how the transmission line is called as two port circuit. So that also I will be showing you in my next slide. So before that, I would like to say, actually in electronic systems, for transferring the power we need some wires for the lower frequencies. So it means for lower frequencies the power transfer can take place using the wires, whereas for electromagnetic means microwave frequencies, what is required means we are using one physical structure. That physical structure will transfer the power, or we can say the power distribution is possible using that physical structure from place to place over a distance, that is called as transmission lines. Okay, it means for lower frequencies we can use a wire, whereas for higher frequencies, microwave frequencies, we are using the physical structure. The physical structure is nothing, it is a transmission lines. Okay, next, this is the transmission line setup, and you can see as I told, the transmission line is a two port circuit element. Here in the case of transmission lines, by this figure you can see source is there, which is sinusoidal in nature, then ZG is there, that is the source impedance, and here ZL is there, that is the load impedance, and it is a similar setup how we are studying about the two port network. Okay, so here what will happen means the power transfer is possible over a distance through this transmission lines. And in this case, actually what I would like to say, one more point, initially or the beginning point, the transmission line was like a lumped circuit. After some time it has been started analyzing, or it has been studied as a distributed element. So what is the meaning of the distributed element means the R, L and C per unit length. It means ohm per meter, Henry per meter and Farad per meter we are studying in case of distributive circuit element, or we can say distributive element circuit. Next point is transmission line supports TEM wave, transverse electromagnetic wave, but the guided waveguide is not supportive to TEM wave. Means transmission line can support TEM wave, whereas the waveguide cannot support TEM wave. Now the question is, what is TEM wave? What is transverse electromagnetic wave? So an electromagnetic wave where both the electric and magnetic fields are perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. It means electric and magnetic fields will be perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation that is called as electromagnetic TEM wave, transverse electromagnetic wave. Okay, next point, here I have drawn the equivalent circuit, and in this equivalent circuit you can see we have all the four parameters, I mean R, L, C and G. Okay, the difference is R and L, it is in series, and C and G, it is in shunt. And transmission lines actually for lower frequencies, okay, means in communication, whereas higher frequencies we are studying in terms of computer network. Next point I would like to add, in case of transmission lines, it is dispersive in nature. So what is the meaning of dispersive in nature? So the meaning of dispersive in nature is the propagation velocity on the time on the line is not constant with frequency. The meaning of dispersive, again I am repeating it, the propagation velocity on the line is not constant with frequency. And the next point is the longer the time, the greater the impact. This is one more point, and it is useful, very much useful, this dispersive properties or nature for high speed digital transmission, like fiber optics and wired networks. And we can see in this figure the impact of transmission line dispersion, means the transmission lines are dispersive in nature. So what are the impacts of that we can see using this figure. Okay, so next class we are going to discuss about the types of transmission line. Till then, you take care. Thank you so much.